For the week of June 6th, 2011, this is the Yokosuka Report on Channel 15. Your place for news on the fleet, service members, and our community.
Sailors, family members, and friends from the Yokosuka area attended the annual Safety, Health, and Environmental Awareness Fair on base in preparation for the critical days of summer. Cordine Kaur, the Director of Safety for Fleet Activities Yokosuka, said safety needs to be on everyone's mind as the weather gets warmer.
It's typically the summer is the time of year when everybody wants to get out. They want to travel, they want to go to the beach, they want to climb Mount Fuji, whatever the case may be. So what we've done is we've brought vendors in here, individuals that are professionals in those areas, to be able to provide information to the sailors and the civilians that are working here at CFAY to help them get through the summer safely.
Captain David Owen, CFAY's commanding officer, said everyone needs to remember things such as operational risk management, or ORM, to keep not only themselves safe, but others as well.
So we need to refresh our memories of how to keep ourselves safe. We need to remember things like ORM. It's not only apply at work, but also at home. Last thing we want to do is we don't want to have anybody lose any friends or family members to something that they could have avoided.
Petty Officer Bryan Reckard, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan. Captain David Owen, the commanding officer of Fleet Activities Yokosuka, was invited to throw the first pitch at a Yokohama Bay Stars minor league team game at Yokosuka Stadium. Owen said that although he was a little weary of his pitching abilities, it was a great opportunity to visit the stadium and support the local team.
They're really tempting fate here. They've asked me to throw out the first pitch for the game tonight, and I haven't really thrown a baseball since college, so we'll see what happens here.
With the help of the Bay Stars, Owen also had the chance to film his monthly Commander's Corner, the informative broadcast about what's happening on base for Yokosuka residents, directly on Yokosuka Stadium's field as the teams warmed up.
What I'm out here doing today is I'm filming my monthly Commander's Corner, which gets information out to the CFAY community. And it was great that the Yokosuka Bay Stars were able to support us. I mean, out here outside at their nice stadium and everything, getting to see their players, going to have a ball game tonight. So it's something different instead of just sitting in the studio.
Yokosuka Stadium is located within a few minutes' walk of the Opama train station. And Owen suggests those stationed in the area get out and try to catch a game. Petty Officer Bryan Reckard, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
Naval Facility Far East biological scientist Scott Vogt begins the first wildlife population density surveys at Ikego, Japan's U.S. military housing compound.
We're trying to document what we have and maintain native species on Navy lands, and Ikego is a beautiful area. I encourage people to come out here and check out the wildlife.
These surveys were brought about in order to comply with Japanese governing standards to monitor and maintain the species' living environment.
A few weeks ago, we did counts on the same stations for the birds. And I collected data for the squirrels using the same method we used for the birds, and I thought it would work to estimate the population of squirrels too. And I think it will, and I needed a few more squirrel numbers to make the statistics work.
The data collected during this survey of a specific breed of squirrel will help aid control the increase or decrease of population density.
It's basically an inventory. So you got to know what you have on your lands if you're going to manage it. And a lot of times management is just leaving things alone, and that's fine. But if something is wrong and you've got to correct it, you've got to know what's wrong.
With more than 16 years of wildlife experience, Vogt is a lead biologist in charge of several species studies around the globe.
I've been doing wildlife work since 1995. Before that, also did fisheries work, fish culture in Africa, fishing boats in Alaska.
Vogt plans to conduct future research studies on more wildlife inhabitants within the Ikego area, which in turn will help determine the population density of multiple forest inhabitants.
Military lands, because we restrict access, the animals tend to do really, really well. And this area, in this region, is one of the few areas of big undeveloped habitat in the Mura Peninsula.
Petty Officer Michael Story, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.